students, welcome back. Today, let us start a new topic in maths for class 4, tessellation.
Look at these patterns on baby quilts. Look at this pattern on floor tiles. Did you like these repeated patterns? These are examples of tessellations. Now, let us see what you mean by tessellation. A tessellation is a pattern made by shapes that fit into each other without leaving a gap or any overlap. A tessellation is also called tiling. The tiles that we use must be regular polygons of the same size, and the tessellation must tile a surface without any gap or overlap. Now, polygons are plain two-dimensional shapes having three or more than three sides. Regular polygons have equal sides and equal angles. Tessellation can be done by using a single shape or by using a combination of more than one shape. Let us see some examples of tessellation done by using same shapes, that is, one single shape. The first figure you can see is of a chessboard. It is an example of tessellation made by using squares. The second figure is an example of tessellation made of triangles of equal sides. Children, such triangles having all three sides equal are called equilateral triangles. This tiling pattern is an example of tessellation made by using rectangles. This is an example of tessellation made by using hexagons. A hexagon is a polygon having six sides. Tessellation is also found in nature. Children, can you identify the picture here? Yes, it is of a honeycomb, and it is a perfect example of tessellation using hexagons. Now, we will see some examples of tessellation formed by using a combination of more than one shape. The first figure is an example of tessellation formed by using hexagons and triangles. The green colored shapes are the hexagons, and the white color shape in the first figure are the triangles. Can you identify the two shapes used in the second figure? Yes, the second figure is an example of tessellation done by using triangles and squares. There are some shapes that do not tessellate. Circles are an example of shapes that do not tessellate. Children, look at the figures drawn below. In these figures, you can clearly see that the circles do not fit into each other, but instead there are gaps between the circles. The shapes that do not form a tessellation are called non-tessellating shapes. Now, we will see some baby quilts which are made by using the concept of tessellation.
The first design here you can see is of a star. Look here children, the tessellation is made by using two shapes, the squares and the triangles. There are some squares here and also you can see a triangles also here, okay? So this is a beautiful design made by using squares and triangles. What is this picture you can see here? Yes, it is of a boat. See how beautiful it looks, children. This again is a tessellation made by using two shapes, triangles and squares. Triangles and squares. Wow, a beautiful red flower, isn't it? Again, this is a very good example of tessellation made by using squares and triangles. Children, see how beautifully they have been done by using or applying the concept of tessellation.
To apply the concept of tessellation, I have a question for you. In the given figures, identify the shapes that tessellate. Yes, the correct answer is the triangle. The triangle is the only figure among the given figures here that will tessellate. Now, I will show you a craft activity to show tessellation using squares.
To do this activity, you need a square paper, you need three craft papers, and of these three craft papers, you have to cut 9 squares. So you will need 4 squares of one color, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 squares of the other color. So according to your choice, keep the craft papers ready. You need a scissor and fevicol or glue to stick the squares. I will be using a combination of blue and red colors. So I have cut the blue craft paper in the similar manner. I have made 5 squares of the red color paper and 4 squares of the blue craft paper. I have taken a red craft paper here and I will first show you how to cut the squares. First, let us fold the paper into half. Press it properly. Now, fold it again one more time so you get a smaller square. Press it properly, children. All the sides. And then, open it and cut the squares with the help of a scissor. Take a scissor and cut the squares here. Do it properly. This way. 1, 2. And similarly, we cut the other two squares. Cut it on the line where you have folded. See here, you get perfect squares. I have got 4 of red color. Now, I will show you how to make the folds. Take one square and fold it like this to form a triangle. Press it well, children. Again, fold it one more time and make one more triangle. See, I have folded it twice. First time, you have to fold and make one triangle, and second time again the next fold to make the second triangle. Now open, and what you have to do is you bring this part here. See here, see the folds I'm making. 1, 2, bring it at the center. 3 and 4. Again, I have made 4 folds and brought all the 4 corners together here. See here, this way. Right, press it well. You get a figure like this. and this is all what we need. Children, I have made and kept ready 3 of these squares. Now, our next step is to stick these squares on the craft paper. Now, take glue or fabricol, put it at the center, spread it with your fingers and stick it here in the corner. Nicely place it on this paper here and stick it here, the first square, see. Now, we will stick the other combination here, that is the blue color. I have taken the glue of fabricol, put it at the center and again join it end to end. So see, this is the concept of tessellation we are using, tiling. The third paper, put some glue and stick it next to it end to end here. Okay, and we will press. Now, I have stuck red, blue and red in a line. Now, the first line you can see, children, I have placed red, blue and red. In the second line, I have stuck blue, red and blue. Now, I will complete this pattern by sticking the last line. On the last line, I will stick red, again, red, red. Next will be which color? Blue. See? Blue. Stick it end to end. The corners have to meet of each square. Okay? And then again red. Spread some blue. And then you can stick. See here? Our pattern is ready. Children, now the pattern is completed. See how beautiful it looks. Now, I have made one more pattern with yellow and pink combination. Like this, you can use different colors and make beautiful patterns of your choice. Please try and do this activity at home.
I hope you have understood the concept of tessellation. See you again in the next video. Till then, take good care of yourself.